Happy Thursday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I got your latest tropical update on what is coming around the corner. Our tropics are about to wake up shortly. Now, you can see over here, starting in the Eastern Pacific, that Invest 91E actually won the battle of the two systems coming together. So you can see that the guidance is taking it on that southern track below Hawaii, which is a great thing. The northern track was by Invest, I believe it was 90E. But 91E did take over. Another thing that's happening is Gilma, Major Hurricane Gilma, is going in that direction as well. But you can see it's going in those cooler waters. You can see how it starts weakening down as it comes towards Hawaii. So far, the latest impacts not showing much at all for Hawaii. Maybe some rainfall, which, again, you need very seriously. You are behind in your drought. Now, going across to the Atlantic side, we do have some waves that's trying to push through. Showing a lot of weakness on these waves as they push around this high pressure, but showing it could be some late-minute formation still, potentially right in the Gulf of Mexico. Maybe just become extra rainfall for y'all. I will keep you updated. And the next couple of waves that is coming off the coast of Africa are actually a little bit southern, where you could get a western travel out of some of these and potentially start forming up in the Eastern Caribbean and go all the way around either into the Gulf or go around Florida by the East Coast, maybe even turn really early and go into the Atlantic. So I'm going to show you all the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year along with my weather forecast, and make sure you hit the like button down below. Help others find this information as well. Thank you so much for your time. Remember, timestamps are always in the description. Help save you time. Hit that share button if you have a moment and help others with that also. Thank you so much. Now, you can also see that literally in 3 to 5 days is when this system is going to be passing by you. And you can see by all the model guidance, they all in agreement, it will be south of Hawaii. This is what the Invest showed before. But with the two Invests going together, they didn't know if it was going to take this track or the northern track. So it looks like you have the best case scenario. The temperatures are nice and warm right here, but once it starts leaving and goes on that west northwest track, it will be going into cooler waters, and this will help weaken down the system. And you can also see, just checking for a chance for a tropical depression, that it does go into that region on Invest 91E right below you. So you might get some impacts on far southern islands of Hawaii. But you see also that Gilma races that way as well, but it goes a little bit of that northern track, and as it gets pushed further to the west, weakens down greatly because of all the cold water. And you can see the far spread. Once it gets around 5 days, really it starts spreading out at 5 days. It really don't know which direction it's going to go. Until then, it's kind of on that western jog. You see the confidence leaving. And it literally could be anywhere from 6 days, which is right here, or even 7 days, or even way out here in 7 days. But you see that north-northwest pattern, and it's going to start weakening down in that direction. And you also can see from Major Hurricane Gilma, it's going to start being on a weakening system as well. And as you go anywhere from 5 days on, you see literally you have a weakening tropical storm that could be potentially pass by you. But at the same time, it's taking that west-northwest track, and all the impacts will be north and east on this system, not on Hawaii at all. And you can see on the latest model guidance, the Euro showing it will be right below you as that passes by. Then as Gilma goes in that direction, you see that west-northwest path also weakening down as it goes. Hurricane analysis forecast model wants to keep thinking of where it's going to still stay somewhat a strong tropical storm, maybe even a low-grade hurricane, but still showing it will pass right below the islands. No impacts on these systems. Now, it's been trending a little bit that after it passes by the islands, it could do a northern turn. I will keep you updated. So far, it's not set in stone. You also see from the Atlantic side, there's nothing in the next 7 days, but showing a possible tricky wave could start popping up into the Gulf of Mexico at the last minute. More likely will bring your rainfall, but we do need to watch it. That Gulf is so hot, it is unbelievable. Then we're going to start getting these waves coming through exactly in 10 days. So obviously, I will keep you updated. We're just trying to follow the pattern. And you see the latest update from Global Tropics. Those that have been following my community tab, they know this update already. That maybe above average rainfall will come out of that first tropical wave. And it will start forming up somewheres over by the eastern Caribbean, somewheres by the Lesser Antilles, and maybe curve, and maybe go a little bit further and curve. But so far, it's just showing formation is in this area. That's all the way to the third. Now, after the third, this is where we have that tropical wave that could go further along Florida or the East Coast. Still not showing that yet, according to Global Tropics. And they're showing these waves could keep going right into the Eastern Pacific or turn all the way to September 10th. So right to our peak of our hurricane season, we literally have something in the MDR that probably will go into the Atlantic. Still, we got to watch it. There's a good potential it won't be fish storms, and it could affect people on the Eastern Caribbean, so we will keep that watched. But at the same time, we're going to our peak of our hurricane season, and this is our outlook. So I want to show you the latest update on a potential velocity anomaly. And you can see from this shot right here where you have Central America, that is right below the Gulf of Mexico, and Florida is right to the east of that, so is Jamaica. I just want you to be aware of that. Because you can see as we transition over towards a potential velocity anomaly, you can see literally according to the GFS, as we go in the very beginning of September, we could have a potential storm forming. Now this looks very weak, but this is the same thing that formed Beryl, just saying that. But at the same time, you can see that western push just bowing out to the west on these waves as you go through September. But GFS is showing you potentially could have something come by Florida, showing something weak, showing it could be something stronger going to the Gulf of Mexico, maybe on the western side, and maybe another wave forming up in the Gulf of Mexico. Now you can see a little bit of this as you go through the latest update, showing that you could get potentially that front-induced low in the Gulf of Mexico, still not showing any formation anywhere. That could bring some rainfall, much needed rainfall, towards Texas as you go by the weekend and into the next week. Also showing that this wave could form up late into the Gulf of Mexico after that and try and spin up really quick before that makes landfall literally 6 and 7 days away. And we don't have an outlook for that yet. National Hurricane Center might put something in there. There's not a lot of confidence in that, but still, as warm as those waters is, all it needs is 24 to 36 hours, and that could be a problem also. But look, as we go from August into September, that wave that was showing forming up somewhere over here by the Caribbean, like I've been posting on my community tab, still you can see two tropical waves, one going to the western Caribbean right around the beginning of September, and this is the one that was showing weaker on GFS. And then we got that next one coming into the eastern Caribbean right in the beginning of September, showing that travels to the west in the Gulf, makes an abrupt turn because of the trough, still too far to know if that's even accurate yet. And that second one starting to get pulled around that high pressure, showing everything's going to change dramatically. I will keep you updated. Take this with a grain of salt. We all know it's past 10 days, and you always got to take it with a grain of salt. When you go to a previous run, it is not there. When you go to a run before that, it showed a maybe in the last few frames. So it's not set in stone about this happening, but there is a transition that is going to go on. And so far, we're seeing weakness according to the GFS potential velocity anomaly. But the models are really taking off with this because of the warm temperatures in this region. So when we go by the ensembles, first the GFS, then we'll go by the Euro. You can see literally as you go from August into September, showing these waves more likely will go into the Atlantic. You see how they're forming up really late. And keep in mind, this is way past 10 days. But it's showing that it will be more of a turn to that direction. And maybe this will go into the Eastern Pacific, not really be formation into the Gulf. But you see how these are showing maybe turning into that direction and growing as you go further and further down the road. We're already 330 hours away. It keeps getting pushed further and further. So when you take a look at the latest potential velocity anomaly, you can see that we do have something that could be going into our Gulf of Mexico sometime after the 6th and 7th. So that is trending a little bit with GFS as well. Then after that, we go into unfavorable, but something still showing around the 11th and 12th, but even weaker. Then Euro is seeing something a little bit further to the east, somewhere by Florida or the East Coast, sometime into the early 20s. Then maybe it'll start waking up a little more wide range after that. So remember my rule, if it's 10 days away or further and it keeps showing 10 days away, just probably above average rainfall more likely will not happen. So let's look with the ensembles with the Euro. And we are literally 11 days away, showing maybe by the time you go 12 days, so you can get that sneaky wave maybe popping up late, very weak, front induced more than likely. And these over here in the Eastern Caribbean start curving more into the Atlantic. and maybe something going to the west. Literally in the last frames. So this is just too far away to take seriously. It keeps pushing us further and further. Climatology, we need to watch out because this is our peak of our season. But look how everything else has gone. Literally, we have 10 good weeks left. Supposed to be our biggest part of our hurricane season. And we have over 15 names. So if that's what's going to happen, like a switch turning on, then we're literally going to have 15 or more storm names within a 10-week period. And that would just be a conveyor belt coming right off the coast of Africa or just forming up in general. And we're not seeing a lot of that yet all the way till the 5th of September, all the way to the 10th of September before probably something will happen. We got a couple of sneaky waves we need to watch. Anything can happen with those warm temperatures, and it only does take one. Just not showing a lot of confidence, that's all. Matter of fact, when you go by the control member of the Euro, it is showing all the way by September 6th. Something very weak passing by the Eastern Caribbean. And you see how it travels west and starts gaining a little bit more strength. I mean, exact track almost of Debbie. And starts turning by Florida, still showing impacts will be Eastern Florida, so it will not be strong impacts in you. Bahamas, we have to watch out for this if this was to show true. But look at this, we're already in the middle of September for our peak of our hurricane season, not showing much at all. And showing if this happens, it will get pulled around the high pressure and get pulled right back into the Atlantic as it potentially strengthens. And we would have to watch out for Bermuda and maybe a curve back to the northeast. It's just not showing a lot of confidence. And then after this one, not showing anything really popping up except something going into the Atlantic. And we're almost at the end of September. This is our peak. Now, we still have that storm system that's coming in from the northwest. And this is still going to be bringing these storms coming in from the southwest, pulling this north, and still bring y'all some storms and a little bit of severe weather that's going to be coming by. Not showing any chances for tornadoes, but you can see how long this lasts, and it does transition across the Great Lakes and the North Central. So for today, you do have chances for severe weather, chances for a little bit of winds and a little bit of hail as this travels by tomorrow. You just got a couple of areas, very small, very minimal chance for any kind of severe weather. The next day, you can see how it stays in that same region as it heads north. But after that, it's going to start moving to the east. So after you go by day four, you see you got that 15%. This probably will lower down a little bit. As you go by day five, you got that 15% chance for severe weather. After that, then it don't have anything. It just moves on into Canada. But we have a little motion coming through that I will keep you updated on. So far, I'm not showing any big deal. Still got all these hot temperatures in the south. As a matter of fact, Texas, you were very hot last year, and so far you're not like last year, but today you are actually going to be beating a lot of those records from last year in a few cities, anywhere from 1 to 4 degrees. But most of all, thank you so much for your time. I do appreciate it. I know everyone is very busy these days, so I am so thankful for you tuning in today. Thank you again. Now, before you go off, 1 Corinthians 2:10-16. But God hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yes, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man, but the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. Which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. But he that is spiritual judgeth all things, yet he himself is judged of no man. For who hath known the mind of the Lord, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. Amen. But remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you tomorrow.